some years ago I did research on the topic of grandparents who had a good relationship with their grandchildren and then suddenly find that that relationship is at risk. It was primarily the result of parental divorce, where one parent is alienated from the child, and once that happens, then the grandparents are usually right behind. And the last time I made the presentation, a few months ago, I got some pushback from the grandparents in the audience, and they were saying, well, actually, you're missing a whole large group of grandparents who are out there, and these are grandparents who've never seen their grandchildren. They put the word out that I'm doing research on grandparents who've never seen their grandkids, and there was like a tremendous response, over 100 grandparents. But it seems that more and more grandparents are at risk of never having a relationship, and this is not due to parental separation. It's a matter of both parents, particularly their own now adult child, who is preventing grandparents from having any contact, not even letting the grandparents know about the birth of a child. And who are these grandparents? Well, these are people who were the victims of parental alienation many years before. We now have, you know, this large group of people who were cut out of their children's lives. And many years later, they haven't reestablished any kind of relationship. And now they've become grandparents too. They hear that there's been, you know, they have a grandchild. It's like a double whammy for them. They're still suffering many years later the loss of their own children, who are now adults, and now they're feeling even more intensely, you know, a sense of loss and grief, and when they learn that they have grandchildren and they have no hope of ever seeing these grandchildren. Parental alienation situations, at least some of these folks have some hope that maybe one day they'll reunite. But these grandparents have absolutely no hope. They feel completely helpless and hopeless and you know, very highly at risk, in my view. You know, I've done research with, you know, children, parents, family members who are the most negatively affected by a divorce and the loss of their children. But I've never seen a group quite as distressed as these parents. Many of them just completely broke down and couldn't continue with the interview and dropped out. But yeah, it was just too raw, the emotions. They're also just so highly isolated. Nobody really knows about them. They don't tell anyone that they're grandparents. They don't tell anyone about their own adult children that they've lost contact with. So just everyday life is so painful for them when they see grandparents or hear, you know people who have grandkids and talk about them. They just can't face it. Their feelings are really for their grandchildren. They're you know, just very sad about the fact that such hatred of a parent was instilled in their own child, that their own child now is instilling that same hatred in their grandchildren. These grandparents used such highly charged words to describe. The word trauma came up, you know, just very severe trauma. The presentation I made here, I used the term primal wound because one of the grandparents used that term. It's a primal, you know, wound, a loss of the greatest, you know, greatest magnitude. They live a life of just deep grief that contains all the major elements of a bereavement. Over several years, decades in some cases, these grandparents. And then when they learn that a grandchild, you know, is there that they have never seen and probably never will see, it's that much more. It adds to their grief and trauma that much more. This is, you know, a group we really don't know anything about, but there are a lot of grandparents out there in that situation. And it just tells you how common and widespread is parental alienation and how many years later it's still having this effect.
Thank you.